Hi class, welcome to another tutorial on CS384. This time we will see in functions what are pass-by value and pass-by reference. So if you have the knowledge of C, you already know what is pass-by value and pass-by reference. But in Python, there is an easier syntax because in C, when you used to do pass-by address or pass-by reference, you had to deal with pointers, addresses, and everything. Python makes all those things simpler. So first we start with pass-by value. Okay, so what happens in pass by value? So I have a list 10, 20, and 30. Basically, I am calling a function, see, change me by value. I am keeping such a name so that it is easier to identify. Okay, so values, let me just write a statement before calling function. So what happens? I have a my list as a list. I have three elements here, 10, 20, and 30. So values before calling the function is my list. So it will print 10, 20, and 30. Then I'm calling the function change me and I'm passing this list. You can see my list is here. So when I'm passing this in this function, what I'm doing is I'm first printing the value before any changes. So again, 10, 20, 30 will be printed. And now see, I'm redefining my list. Okay. My list is redefined as 1, 2, 3, 4. And then I'm printing the values and finally I'm printing the values in the main. So let us now execute so that it becomes a clearer picture, right? So this is our code. Let us scroll it a bit so that the entire code is visible in a single screen. So now you see values before calling the function. So I have my list here. Values before calling function is 10, 20, 30, which is exactly what we required because I did not make any changes. Then I'm calling the function. Change me by value and I'm passing my list. So indirectly I'm passing 10, 20, 30. So this gets copied here. This gets copied here. And now in the function, you see, I'm saying print values inside the function before change. Values inside the function before change is 10, 20 and 30. Okay, 10, 20 and 30. So this prints perfectly. Now I'm changing the list as my list 1, 2, 3, 4. And then I'm again printing the value. So values inside the function after change. So you see values inside the function after change becomes 1, 2, 3, 4. So basically you have modified my list. You have again modified my list, right? Now values outside the function. So what happens? Return. But see, I'm not returning anything, just a blank return. So when you return the function, where does it go? It goes to the place where it was called. It was called at this position. So when you type return, it basically the cursor comes at this particular position. I'm indicating by a hash just to show where the function will return. Now I am see printing the values of my list again. Remember my list you modified in the function. But strangely it prints 10, 20 and 30. That means the change that you made did not reflect. Because what happens in Python, when you pass anything by value, right? So you had my list and you had passed my list as a variable here, as a parameter here. This gets copied here, right? Once this gets copied here, an identical copy is created in the memory, right? So this my list is basically different than this my list, okay? So the function had its own my list. And the main had its own my list. So whatever changes you made were made basically in this local copy of my list and not in the main. So this is called pass by value. So that you are basically Xeroxing. You are copy pasting this value into this my list, even though the name is same. Okay. So this is basically pass by value. Now what happens if you actually want to change the value of my list? That is what happens in pass by reference. Remember one thing in Python, whenever you are changing the name, if you are modifying by the name, see, this is the name. I'm just initializing my list to 1, 2, 3, 4. Those changes are local changes. If you want to modify the actual values, you have to change by reference. Now, how does changing by reference mean? Okay. So let me comment out the part for change by value because you have already seen. So let me comment out this part. So control and forward slash is for toggling comment and DOS. For example, I'm on this line. I press control and I'm keeping the control key on and I'm keeping the slash key. So control slash is toggling comment. See, uncommented, commented, commented, uncommented, right? So now let me do one thing. I have this code. Let me toggle. So what I'm doing now, I am passing the same thing, right? I'm passing my list and I'm calling the function change me by reference. So what happens? Say my list passes. So 10, 20, 30 is passed. Now just see what happens in change me by reference. See, I am still passing my list, but I am actually referring it by the index value of the list. So I am saying whatever list is passed, change the index of 2 to 50. So what was my original list? Let me just copy here. I am keeping it commented so that I can take a reference. So this is my 0th element, 0th index, first index and second index. Now instead of just specifying in this fashion, reinitializing the whole list, I am changing the index. So whenever you work with indexes, Python will actually modify the actual list, right? Python will modify the actual list. Remember this. Whenever you are working with only names, like this case, nothing will happen. It is just a temporary copy. But if you are referencing by indexing, remember, if you are referencing by indexing, it will actually change the original list. So what happens here when I'm passing 10, 20, 30, my list get copied here, 10, 20, 30. And the second index is actually changed to 50. So now when I'm returning it, you will actually see that the list becomes 10, 20 and 50. Let us execute the code. See, there it is. So my list was 10, 20, 30 values before calling the function. So it was 10, 20, 30. Then you are calling the function myList, which basically is 10, 20, 30. In the function, it prints values inside the function before change. Before change is 10, 20, 30, right? Before change is 10, 20, 30. Then I'm doing an index change. I'm modifying the second index. So the function changes will actually reflect in the main. So after the changes, say this is index number 2, 0, 1, and 2. So myList will become 10, 20, 50. And finally, I am returning. So when you return, where do you return? From the place where the function was called, at this position. Now I am again printing the value of my list, which is 10, 20, and 50. The basic rule to remember is, if you are working with index, the function will also make the changes in the main part. If you are only working by the name of the list and you don't make use of indexes, it will not make any change in the main part. Now you may be wondering that, okay, is it something to do with the name here? No, not at all. So when you are passing my list, let us say I carry this as Joker. Okay, since I'm catching this as Joker, I have to make everything as Joker. Okay, now let us try to execute the code. You see, even though I use Joker here, my changes were reflected in the main as well as function. So it is not necessary that the list name that you are passing has to be the same. This can be anything. See, I kept as Joker. But if you are working with indexes, it will have a reflection on the main list also. So this is how change by reference and change by value work in Python. That's it for this tutorial.